There's nothing like home food. There's no doubt about that. So this week, the MetroPlus team, meaning yours truly primarily, made his way to the homes of three women whose kitchen are not only magical places where they create the most delicious dishes, but are also popularizing traditional organic home cooking by conducting personalized classes. Take a look at how Mrs. Jigyasa Giri, Mrs. Pratibha Jain, realized their love for traditional Indian food and are now spreading it all over the world with grace. It was during one of their trips to Bangalore that Jigyasa and Pratibha realized their common love for cooking. Jigyasa's aunt by law, Pidata, loved narrating recipes that had been passed down generations. Tech-savvy Pratibha avidly noted down 60 recipes in her laptop, and the result was their first book together, Cooking with Pidata.
I got to know Pratibha because I was her daughter's dance teacher. Actually, I teach Kathak, and I used to travel to Bangalore to learn Kathak from my guru also. And that's how Pratibha and I decided to travel together after a point. And I used to go to meet my husband's aunt, Pedata, and she was, of course, the best cook in the family. And she had recipes of traditionally handed down recipes of generations. So that's how we started taking down her recipes.
After their love for Pidata and her homemade recipes had translated into a book, it was soon followed by another. Sukamayu chronicles recipes that use only Ayurvedic elements in them. Each page opens up to a delicious homemade dish replete with nutrition. One among their favorites is a soya pulao, which is a mouth-watering combination of ghee, soaked soya and the royal basmati rice. As the princely aroma of the rice cooked with cumin seeds wafts through the air, Pratibha explains how correct tempering is the most important aspect of Indian cooking. From the perfect kitchen setup to correct tempering is what is taught to the eager students who range from newly married women to bachelors who are going abroad.
Yes, foreigners, tourists and a couple of youngsters who are very early passionate about wanting to learn, and you know, were very interested in how we had done our research and so on. What we do in whenever we have taken classes is we concentrate on the basics. It's not about the recipe. If you get your basic methodology in place, then one can cook after that. So it's like, how do you set up the kitchen? How do you make sure that everything is neat and clean? How do you learn tempering, which Jigyasa and me both feel is really the keystone of Indian cooking. Okay. So once you get your aromas and flavors right, then the rest is a fantastic journey ahead that anyone can enjoy. And yes, that is kind of what we have really shared with the people who have come.